Falcons are this kind of really neat thing where you have this very like historical cultural aspect that's intertwined with this really kind of weird, different evolutionary story that's pretty unique within birds. So I work for the Falcon Genomics Project, and the goal of the project is to tie research being done here at New York University Abu Dhabi into sort of the broader local heritage of falconry and global heritage of falconry. It seeks to support applications in falconry, so falcon racing, falcon conservation, but also answer a lot of basic biological questions in falcons. Falcons are relatively unique birds, or fairly unique birds, and we think by studying falcon genomics we can actually answer a lot of broader questions about evolution in general, speciation in general. Falcons belong to a lineage that diverged from all the other birds about 60 million years ago. Most birds have 82 chromosomes, or around 80 chromosomes. Humans have 46. Falcons, it's actually have 50. It's very unusual. They're actually one of the most diverse genera of birds. There's approximately 40 species of falcons that have appeared very recently and radiated very rapidly, and then gone on to cover the globe, basically. There's not falcons in Antarctica, but the peregrine falcon is actually the most broadly distributed bird in the world. In falcons, I think we have a real possibility in this system to really look at what makes two animals that are different species different from each other at the molecular level. And we think, though, with the samples we have, we'll actually be able to look and see, though, what just areas of the genome are changing and evolving. What becomes challenging is that access to samples of many falcon species is easy here in the Middle East, but knowing ourselves what the purity of those samples are or where they come from, that becomes very challenging. For our reference genomes, we picked samples that we were very certain of. I'm working with several veterinarians who are indispensable, and they're kind of, what samples do you want? And it was sort of like, anything where you can tell me for sure you know where it's from and what it is are really what we care most about.
When I first arrived, all falcons used for falconry were wild caught. The Convention of International Trade of Endangered Species was reinforced in this country, in the UAE, and it's been reinforced in other countries that prohibiting the use of wild-caught individuals. The hybrids are the major change, or crossbreds, if I may say, is the major change in falconry for the last few years.
People have been moving falcons around where they can breed, where they wouldn't naturally breed otherwise. And then now people just breed falcons all the time, and they mix species and everything else. You have situations where people, let's say, bring falcons into one country and they get confiscated or something like that, and we don't even currently have the genomic knowledge to know where to return them to.
These species are much more susceptible to diseases, whereas the traditional species that were used before laws and regulations prohibited the use of wild-caught birds, these birds were much more resistant to diseases.
We already do have dramatically more complete genomes than are currently out there, and we believe the very comprehensive approaches we're taking will make these falcon genomes some of the most complete genomes for any vertebrate.